Good morning, everybody. We are going to start Chapter 2, Introduction to Java. In the Chapter 2, we are going to discuss about various points. The points are here: History of Java, Understanding Bytecode, Ordinary Compilation Process of Normal Softwares, Normal Programming Language, Java compilation procedure and Java execution and interpretation process, characteristics of Java, one sample program, and what are the different types of Java programs are there. This is the part one of our studies of chapter two. Part two will follow after this. First, we are going to discuss about the Java. Java is a programming language and a platform. It's a both. So here we can write the program, we can write the source code, as well as it works as a platform. So as you know, your Java is having a platform. The platform means through which we are interpreting, like our operating system works as a platform. So that's the reason when we create any program in using any specific computer languages, there particular language is depends on a particular operating system, and it can execute its object file on that operating system itself, nowhere in other operating system. But Java, when it generates the object file, it generates in a form of bytecode, and that can be executed using the Java virtual machine in any other operating system. Java virtual machines are actually dependent on a specific operating system or platform, and they can easily translate those codes which you have generated as the codes were generated and in the form of bytecode. Anyway, the Java history starts along back in 1991 when James Kusling developed this particular software. Initially, it was known as Oak. Later on, after few years, it has changed its name from Oak to Java. In the year 1993, when the WWW or World Wide Web application started, then a very interesting thing happens. The limitation of any programming language appears visible to all the people. Why? Because in internet, all the users use different types of operating system, and the program which is generated using Windows cannot be executed in Unix, whereas the program generated using Unix cannot be operated in other language. As you can see, the procedure of ordinary computer languages is that you write the source code and give it to the specific in a specific operating system using a compiler. You are compiling that source code into object code. That object code become dependent on that operating system. Suppose if I am using C language for Macintosh, and using the C compiler I generate a program object file, and that object file can be executed only in Macintosh, cannot be executed in Unix or other operating system. Similarly, if you generate any program using Windows, it cannot be used in Unix. So the limitation appears, and in internet we need to come out of this limitation. To come out of this limitation, we have a language that is called Java. Java come out of this particular limitation. The process of converting source code into machine code is called compilation, as you know now. Now how the things are happening is shown in that picture. So we can move into the next part. Here you can see, first we write how the Java is working here. We write the source code, and then source code is compiled using the compiler, similar like the previous one. But after compilation, it doesn't create anything which is system dependent. It creates the bytecode, and the bytecode is very light codes. Hardly any programming language in our Java, when we generate a bytecode, it will be somewhere around 15k or 20k or 25k of a huge programs, but it is very small in size. That is called bytecode, and that bytecode is also known as the object file. And this generated object file you will send to the Java virtual machine. Java virtual machine, what it will do, it will translate and execute. Java virtual machine is actually an interpreter which will interpret this bytecode and generates the execution. And when it is executed, you will find that Java bytecode is been executed. So executor of the Java bytecode is Java virtual machine. Now let's see the definition. First, source code is a program code. The code written in programming language by the programmer is called source code. Then Java compiler, Java is known as a Java compiler, which compiles that and translate this source code into the executable code or object file. And then what is here, it is different little bit, because object file is not executed directly. It requires a support system of Java virtual machine, which is actually a platform dependent. In different platform you have a different virtual machines, and that virtual machine can execute a common thing that is called bytecode. And that is what exactly how the Java programming work out. Now we move in, what is Java? So Java is a programming language, it's a platform, both. Now when you create any kind of program using Java language, then that can be executed in a different platform. So Java is, I told you what is the meaning of platform. Platform means it's an interpreter, which is refers to some combination of hardware and software. The Java platform is a software platform designed to deliver, run highly interactive, dynamic and secure application and network computer system. As I told you, its original name was worked and developed by James Gosling. Then with the help of Java, what we generate is a bytecode. After compilation of source code by Java, it generates an object code in the form of 0 and 1 or machine language, is known as bytecode. This code are not platform dependent. They just need a JVM to be executed. JVM are of individual platform. That means for Windows we have a different JVM, for Android we have a different JVM, for Unix we have a different JVM. That is the reason you might have seen that in your mobile, if your Java is not enabled, so it will be asking to enable your Java. It is nothing but the JVM it is asking. Java.exe is called JVM, and that need to be active to execute the different Java program on the internet. Now you see here the source code which we create using the Java, they are having a specific extension. Now when you write a program in Java, you give the extension called .java. That means if I have written file as a name of the file, then the program name will be file.java. And after compilation, the source code is generated, and source code has been compiled by the compiler, and it will be generating a code that is known as, that will be having an extension called .class. Now if we look at the interpretation process, what is the process of interpretation, Java execution process? Programs written in Java are compiled into a special type of machine language called bytecode. To interpret this machine code into different platform, an interpreter called JVM is used. This is also known as JIT. J just-in-time compiler. This is known as just-in-time compiler. Now, if we just see what are the various characteristics of Java, you can find once you have written the program, they do not require any kind of separate compilation. It can be executed in any other programming language. So you have to write once and it can be executed anywhere, any kind of platform. Lightweight, as I told you, it generates a bytecode which takes a very less space in the memory. That's why it is known as light code. Then next we move into the security level. As you know, Java is, all the data are protected, as I discussed in the previous class, that all the Java data are protected, encrypted. That's the reason the security level is very high. It's an object-oriented programming, so any kind of mistake can be easily rectified. That is the reason the object-oriented programming benefit can be taken out of Java. Platform independent. It do not require any kind of platform. It is not a Windows-based or Unix-based or any kind of Macintosh-based platform is going to make any kind of hinder into the execution of the Java program. Now, what is a Java program? How to write a Java program? Java program need a structure. Now, if you look at the structure here, which can be called as an encapsulation procedure. How we encapsulate, we write the class name. How we write everything we keep inside the class. You can see the data member, constructor, functions, all the things are there inside a class. How to start a class? We write the first access specifier. Then we use a keyword. The keyword name is class. And then we write the class name. Please remember, the class name we will be writing after this. If I am having a two name, that means here you can see class name, the two words I have used. And these two words should start with the capital letter. This is the Java programming convention. So when you are writing any kind of Java class, the class name convention is saying that if I am using number of words for writing a particular identifier or the name of the class, then it should start with the capital letter for each word. Here I have written class and name in C and L in capital letter. That is the reason. Next, inside the class, what we keep? First, we keep the data member. Data member can be having a specific access specification, public, private, protected, whatever the access specification. Those are the part of access specification we'll discuss in the following classes. Next is the constructor. The constructor is a very important thing which actually initializes the basic properties of class. The basic properties of the class are data members. Then we use a method to manipulate those data values. To manipulate these data values, we use a different kind of procedures, and these procedures are known as method, and these method identifiers are known as function name. Method identifier means the name of the method is called function name. And through the method, we can pass a different types of values. And the values can be passed using the parameter list. If you don't want to pass any kind of parameter, that is empty, then in that case, we don't require any kind of parameters. Now, whenever you are using a parameter, here one int, I have written public int method. Int is actually the return type. Now, you can give that type of value over here. And the return is nothing but the keyword. Remember, return is nothing but the keyword. Now we move into the Java, different type of Java program. There are two types of Java program. One is called standalone, another is called applets. Standalone, this type of application does not require low-level operating system or hardware access. Multiple access can be created. Multiple classes can be created. You need to have a public class through which you can implement objects of different classes inside the main function. And only this executable class and source code file name should be same. Remember, if you are creating number of classes, you can create within the Java program number of classes. But the name of the file, the .java file, which actually saving the source code, that name and the class where you are using the main function should have the same name. Anyway, this is not for BlueJ, this is for the Java core Java concept. Now we move into the next point. Internet applets are small program that are embedded in web pages and run on viewer's machine in a secure manner. It runs on your viewer's machine in a secured manner by the Java capable browsers. So as I told you a few minutes back, that if your browser is not Java enabled, it will not execute the internet applets. So in the internet, when we see the different kind of programs, Java programs, they are called applets.